I am Professor Rai Asgar. I am head of Department of Pediatrics at Rawalpindi Medical University, and I am looking after pediatric department of three hospitals which are attached with this university. One is Benazir Bhutto Hospital, Holy Family Hospital, and District Headquarter Hospital. Well, today we will talk about nutrition during first 100 days, 1,000 days. Well, in Pakistan, the major problem in pediatric age group is that about 40, more than 40% of the children, they are having stunting. Stunting is basically not only you see child growth is affected, but its brain is also affected. So it's basically a chronic malnutrition. So chronic malnutrition affects you see children's each and every system. Physical activity, physical growth, and mental and brain growth. So ultimately, these patients, they have difficulty in schooling, they have school failures, and then these patients, they are having, you see, less memory, and their physical growth is less, and they are prone to have repeated infections and different diseases. And ultimately, their, you see, potential to earn also decreases. So that is also reflected in, you see, overall earning or a capital of a country. So basically, if we talk about nutrition, it starts from conception. So from conception till 2 years of age is basically that window of 1,000 days where this is a crucial period where patient, where a child, if given adequate nutrition, will having a full potential to grow. So we can divide it into maybe three parts. One is conception. So here, once the conception starts, pregnancy starts, so nutrition becomes very important. So here it's the mother's health which is really important. And if maternal health is good and mother is given adequate nutrition, as per the calories are enough and other micro and micronutrients are there and there is no deficiency, then the baby fetus is having full potential and baby would be born with a good, you see, weight, and that is called appropriate growth weight of the child. And otherwise, baby may be born with the small for gestational age, and baby who are having small for gestational age, having less weight, these are having many, you see, problems. So on one hand, we have to keep an eye on maternal, you see, diet. We have to advise to the mother to supplement, you see, diet. And if any deficiency is there, if mother is anemic, then we have to supplement with iron or folic acid or other, you see, nutrients. Secondly, once the baby is born, and if the baby is preterm or full term or low birth weight, so another thing which is really important is that within first hour of the birth, we should start breastfeeding. And this breastfeeding must be exclusive breastfeeding for initial 6 months of life. Exclusive breastfeeding is certainly, it's obvious, exclusive means exclusive. So we will not add anything. So we will give only and only breast milk, and no water, no honey, no you see, supplement, any other milk, nothing. Just we will give mother's milk. WHO is also recommending exclusive breastfeeding for initial 6 months of life. And the baby is, if on exclusive breastfeeding for initial 6 months of life, then baby is protected from many infections, many problems. So if baby is put on bottle milk or is given or even supplemented with bottle milk, then the baby is at risk of acquiring infections like diarrhea, like pneumonia, and other infections. Regarding breast milk, it's obvious to, I hope, everyone that although the mothers, they also know, okay, breast milk is the best UC food, but we have to convince and we have to motivate the mother that breast milk is the best food, and this is complete nutrition for the child. And this is the natural food which contains each and every ingredient, and there is no need to then supplement if the baby is getting breast milk, exclusive breastfeeding. So regarding breastfeeding and regarding its successful breastfeeding, we should go back and we should start this counseling session while the mothers attend, you see, our antenatal clinic. So once the mother is pregnant and comes for antenatal clinic, there we should convince and counsel the mother regarding breastfeeding. That's the best, you see, time to counsel the mother, to prepare the mother for breastfeeding. Because breastfeeding, this is totally related with, you see, hormonal, and it's depends upon, it's dependent upon the brain and hormones. So if mother is committed, if a mother is willing and to breastfeed, the only then she would be able to breastfeed, and only then you see she would be able to produce adequate, you see, milk for the baby. Well, human milk is, as I said, is a complete nutrition and for the baby. And milk is basically species specific, and interestingly, it's also specific regarding the gestational age. So if preterm delivery, so mother will produce milk which is more beneficial for the preterm baby, and for term baby certainly these this is slightly different, and but containing all micro and macronutrients. Not only you see nutrients, but also there are certain other, you see, ingredients which will not only enhance the growth of the brain and eyes and other organs, but will also prevent the baby from certain infections. So breast milk not only contains immunoglobulins, but also it contains macrophages, it contains WBCs and other, you see, cellular component. At the same time, immunoglobulins, secretory IgA is present in a large amount, and that will not only protect the gut of the baby from infections, but also that will enhance the growth of the intestinal cells. There are many other, you see, factors which will enhance the growth of intestine and other, you see, organs. So breastfeeding should be done during the day as well as during night, and mother should breastfeed after every 3 to 4 hours, but it should be a demand feeding. Whenever the baby requires milk, so mother should give you see milk. But it's important that mother should breastfeed the baby during day as well as night, and she has to certainly increase her diet, and she has to take adequate fluids, and then this milk would be adequate. There is no need to supplement, you see, from, you see, any other food or any other, you see, milk. Then at 6 months of age, we give, you see, complementary feeding, which is called a weaning food. Weaning food or complementary food must not be started before 6 months of age, and this is WHO recommendations. And so that the baby should get exclusive breastfeeding till 6 months, and from 6 months onwards we will start with complementary feeding. Well, at 6 months the baby is would be well nourished and will be ready to accept oral, you see, food, and here we can complement. Well, regarding complementary feeding, which we start at 6 months, should be gradually introduced, and we will introduce one food, and we will select those foods which are acceptable to the baby, and which is also culturally also acceptable, and which should be nutritious, easily digestible. Well, in Pakistan, culturally we advise few, you see, foods, and we initially introduce rice based cereals initially, and then after, you see, few weeks we can introduce another food. Commonly we start with cereal, rice cereals and rice based cereals initially, and then we can add banana, mashed banana. Banana also contains a lot of nutrition. It's easily digestible, available round the year, it's available everywhere. And then the third food which we usually commonly introduce is rice based khichdi, which is made from rice along with pulses, two parts of rice and one part of pulses, and we can add, you see, additional oil and it should be so that it should be palatable. And we can later on also add vegetables and maybe meat, minced meat in that this food. That would be more nutritious. The problem in older children from 6 months onwards, when we give complementary feeding, is that stomach of the baby is small, so we have to give small feeding that should be more nutritious, rather than ke bulk should be less and nutrition should be more. So it should be a nutritious food, concentrated. So that can be done by adding some vegetables, maybe meat or some egg can be added in that you see khichdi. And then we can add a few spoons of oil that would be more palatable, and that will contain more calories. Well, we have to introduce this complementary feeding from 6 months, and then we have to keep an eye so that the baby gets micro and micronutrients. Well, in Pakistan, the problem, as I already highlighted, that 43% of children, they are having stunting and chronic malnutrition. So our children are deficient not only in macronutrients but also in micronutrients. So we have to keep an eye on micronutrients also, because the micronutrients are also needed. They are having many, you see, roles in growth of the brain and other organs, and in immunity. So if we add, you see, meat and we add egg, so micronutrients deficiency can be corrected. Otherwise, we have to give maybe iron supplementation or other. So in regarding micronutrients, iron is very important, zinc is very important. Well, in Pakistan, there is zinc deficiency in children because our soil is deficient in zinc. So if baby is deficiency of zinc, these children are prone to have repeated infections, repeated diarrheas, repeated pneumonias. And zinc is having a role in immunity also. So if we give zinc to these children who are having diarrhea, then they will improve quickly, and the chances of recurrence of diarrhea is less, and more, you see, complications are also less. That's why WHO also recommends you see zinc to each and every child who is having diarrhea. Similarly, other micronutrients and vitamins, vitamin A, vitamin D, and vitamin K and E, these fat soluble vitamins are also important. And these can be, there is, if the child is getting adequate and balanced diet. So if child is getting milk will contain vitamin D. And if we give egg and meat, then the requirement of vitamin D would be adequately met. Otherwise, certainly these patients should have, you see, exposure to sunshine, because the vitamin D, which is made by through sunshine, is having is better and is more quantity and having more half life. So we should advise to the mother to give, you see, sunshine to their children. Vitamin D deficiency problems are also common in Pakistan, although okay, there is no depth of sunshine, a lot of sunshine is there, but again we have to counsel the mothers regarding to sunshine their children, and to keep playing or place the child in sunshine, and this sunshine should be direct exposure to sunshine, and the best sunshine is from 10 a.m. till 4 p.m. And regarding, you see, other vitamins, these if needed they can be added, but if we give better nutrition, then balanced diet is given. And the child who is 1 year of age, we recommend ke 1 year old child should eat food which is available in the house. The other, you see, parents and other children, whatever they are eating, a 1 year old child should start eating. So we should continue tasting, giving the opportunity to the child to taste the food of which is homemade food. And breastfeeding should be continued till 2 year of age. According to you see, our Quran, our God also says that mothers should breastfeed their children till 2 year of age. So this is very important, ke mother should continue breastfeeding even after you see 6 months of age, once we start with complementary food, because this is a complete nutrition that will continue till 2 years of age. And then after 2 years, child would be adequate and child will continue, you see, eating homemade foods. Then if the baby is on breast milk for initial 6 months and complementary feeding started at 6 months of age, where you see we have to keep an eye not only on quantity but our quality and frequency, so that patient is prevented from malnutrition, so child will grow and will have full potential, will achieve height, not only height and physical growth but also mental growth, and that will ultimately become a useful citizen. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.